Let us shout hallelujah. In the precious name of Yeshua HaMashiach, we greet you all. You may be seated in Yeshua's name. Let us, Yisrael, we're going to have Baptist Zion, the bath. The singers of Kol Teshua community sing. We greet you all that have joined us, Yeshua's mighty name, as we come to celebrate, as Yah commands us, this Kimpurah, this Kimpurim, this covering, the kafa, the covering of our sins through only the atonement of the Dam, Yeshua HaMashiach. So as we prepare our hearts to receive and to offer up unto him the excellent offering that he commands us in Yeshua, that's the only way that we can offer unto him the excellent gift that he commands us. It's only through Yeshua HaMashiach. Because within our own capabilities and strengths, we do not have that ability. So I barach Yah for the Dam, Yeshua HaMashiach, that gives strength unto his nation, his people, that we may come into his bayat with exceeding gladness for what he has done for us as a nation, a people. In the midst of this shabi, this captivity, as we are entangled with yokes of bondage of the world, as we constantly are in opposition by the enemy of our nefesh, that he grants unto us the wisdom of Torah, simple truth, that we may walk in the power of that truth, and that's vitally important. We greet you all that have joined us for this khafa, the covering of our sins and the washing away through the testimony of power, and that testimony is only in Yeshua HaMashiach. It is in no other name. It is by the power of no gods, no lords. It is only in that name that express the Yoshach, the deliverance of Yah. That is in the name of Yeshua HaMashiach. We can purport any other name we want to, but there is only one name. Because there is only one S-U-N, isn't it? There is only one M-O-O-N. Irregardless to what scientists say, that there are spheres and there are other types of planets that may have 10, 20 moons, but Yah said he made one. He made Ichad. He made one sun. They will say that there are many suns. No, there's only one S-U-N, the Shemesh that Yah ordained. It's only one. It's only one. And it governs the province of Yah as he commands, as he has laid it out, it does that, Yisrael. You see how science and man twist the way of Yah and tell you, well, on that planet, they have 30 moons. And on that planet, there are 5 or 6 suns that are greater than the Shemesh of Yah. But Yah says he created the sun, the ruler, the power of his ore, of the light. And the moon, the lesser, to rule and to govern the night season. That's what Yah says. And what man says is that there are many. What man says, his name is not Yah, his name is Lord God. What man says, his name is not Yeshua, it's Jesus and Lord. Damn lies. Vitally important that we know and understand. I delight on this Shabbaton, this time of rest, the purpose of Yah to be expressed among his people, that we search our love for the leaven, the sin, the wickedness, that cause us to be besieged in our ways, that we are not faithful unto Yah. We are a faithless generation. We're without faith. We may think we do, but we're without the emunah of Yah because we don't give a damn and we do not trust him. Come on, Teshua singers. You'll come sing. You that have joined us, we greet you all. In Yeshua's mighty name, may the riches of Yah rest upon you all. We're going to hear some preaching and singing today, some teaching. Whatever way Yah guides me and leads me, that's where I will go. Come on, my Ach Yosipi Yah, our precious anointed one of Yah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Ah, yes. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Cannot go around the Torah. Yahweh, who
Sing that song for another 10-15 minutes. As in the days in the houses that we were gathering in all of our ignorance, we began to sing a song like that, everyone would sing. The whole house would be full, filled with that great majesty, even in our ignorance, because we were submissive and we wanted to find the way. We didn't know Yisrael. Our leaders, even in that time, did not beguile us because of their craftiness. They were simply ignorant, as I was and as you were. They did not know. They did not understand the magnificence of the covering, the kafa of Yeshua. And so through the process of their teaching, what they had learned, that's the way they taught us. They did not know. They did not understand. And what Yah does in this hour, as he began to move by the power of his Ruach, we must be filled with the Ruach of Yah. He speaks indelibly to the minds, the leba, the heart of Yisrael, through the revealing of the pages of the Sefer, the book, the Torah, the writ, the writing, that he has placed among us as a nation, and with those that have allowed his khatab, the writing, the inscribing of his Torah in our minds. And then you will hear Torah, Imat, the truth that will truly make us free and segregate us from this world, that we will be different than the world. We will come out of the world. We will come out of a system of logics and thinking. And then only will we allow the mind of Yeshua HaMashiach to let that mind, that labah, be in us that was in Yeshua. And that mind does one thing, one of the most valuable things it does for us. It reveals the power of our Abba, because it is a mind that testifies of the Most High. And that is what that mind will do. We greet you all, Yisrael, wherever you are, Yeshua's name. I am going to take a relaxed position today. I want to teach because I wanted to continue on the last day message that I began on the two witnesses of Yah. But this is vital that I would teach concerning this time that we're in. And this message can be played every atonement, every Kippurah, for those that are coming into the knowledge of the truth, that have no wisdom of this Imat, and then they can learn from this teaching that I will do today. And I want to somewhat be methodical about this teaching, that we as a nation of people may grasp the entirety of what Yah speaks unto us. It's not every word that Yah speaks is pure. And we are the abits of Yah, his servants, those that serve him willingly with pleasure. That is what an abit is. It is one that serves him with a pleasure of delight, that he is our master, and we delight in the fact that the Most High, the Creator, is our master. And everything that we do, it is to his chavetz, his will, his pleasure, and what causes his love to delight. Isn't that vitally important, Yisrael? That's what I want. So I will take my time today. This is Yom Kippur. So we are going to sit in the presence of Yah. And then when we leave from here, we're going to continue our rest and delight in the testimony of Yeshua HaMashiach. Is that not vitally important unto us? Well, it is to me if it's not to anyone else. Wisdom is principle, the chuchmah, the experience, and that is what wisdom is. Our experience with Yah, what is that experience based upon? It is through the elementary teaching of Torah. It's how we interact or react. When we hear the Torah of Yah taught unto us, our response, what kind of activities are performed in our minds when we hear the Torah? That is wisdom. When it becomes a living spiritual practicality of our lives, that's wisdom. But then in all of that, we have to get understanding. Wisdom is principle, but the being, the understanding, the power to discern the truth, the wisdom of Yah, that is vitally important. And that's what we need, Yisrael. Again, we berach you all that have joined us, or Baruch Yisrael, Yoshua's mighty name. I want to begin this teaching today, but before I do that, I have a few letters I do want to read. They're not long, they're brief. They're those that sincerely desire to serve Yah, and their testimony speaks of the fervor and the passion when their sins are corrected, when their eyes are open to the knowledge of truth, that they realize it's going to take not just that, what they have, Shemach, but it's going to take the fullness of his Torah. That is why Yoshua HaMashiach, he was filled with Chol, the fullness of the Ruach HaKodesh. It was poured out upon him without measure. There is a measure poured out upon us because Yah will not allow us to blaspheme his Ruach. He will not allow us to do that. We cannot take the mind of Yeshua and integrate it with the world. We cannot continue in the habitual habits of our flesh. And you know that it is fleshly because our flesh man rejoices in it. It is thing that is purported of Yah that is demonstrated in us. Our natural mindset will disapprove of it. It will hate it. It will despise it. It will not like it. And anything that our natural proclivity delights in, and that is our desire of our flesh, we know that it's not of Yah. We know that it's not of Yah because that mind is enmity against Torah. It's not a mind that reflects Torah. Only the mind, Yoshua HaMashiach, is a mind that reflects the Torah of Almighty Yahweh. Any other mind reflects a devious attack to destroy, to throw down, and to break down the assurance and surety of Torah. That mind we operate in. We must operate in the mind of Yoshua HaMashiach. I want to read these letters, and they have come from different parts of the earth. And the pigmentation of the people varies from one to the extreme of the others. I was talking to my Ach Simeon, and I said, it is amazing that the true light of Yisrael, we all talk the same talk. And we speak the same language. There's a language that is pure. It is a voice that expresses the beauty of Almighty Yah. I want to read a few letters here for us, Yisrael. This one is from a precious bath there in the country on the Isle of Grenada. She writes unto me, Dear Reach David, for over 30 years I have waited for the truth in the churches, but did not find it. I am a retired educator here in my island, Grenada, West Indies. Nevertheless, to say, I listen to your teachings and your preaching, and I turn toward Yerushalayim with your congregation every Shabbat to pray. I am so happy to have received your emails. I keep the feasts and the high Shabbats, and I do look forward to the Feast of Tabernacle to call my family and friends and to read from the Torah when we gather to have some meals in a booth on my patio. You will hear from me again because you are my pastor for the past several months now. Be encouraged, my beautiful pastor, a true man of Yahweh, and your beautiful Isha, and all the members of Teshua community. Sincerely in our Hamashiach, our precious Beth Joyce Gibbs. From the island of Grenada, I read one from the Appalachian, from the hills of West Virginia. Concerning the Appalachians, they stretch from Georgia all the way to Maine. But only the state of West Virginia is truly Appalachia because it is all mountain terrain. I received this letter. It says, Greetings of Shalom, Reach David Yisrael. We pray all is well with you and those you oversee at Teshua community. A card containing an offering was sent around the middle of September, but all was returned intact. I have enclosed the original envelope and a money order for inspection. Are you having problem with the mail, my ach? We have also enclosed an additional offering for Yah's works. You are a trusted ach in Yeshua, so we are compelled by Almighty Yahweh to share our limited financial resources at this time for the kingdom work. It appears Yah may be opening the storehouse for an abundance of resources to be made available for our mutual use. And they greet me, hallelujah. If it is Yah's will, his hafetz's pleasure, for us to join all of you on Sukkah, we will be there. If not, you all are certainly in our prayers, as always. We have plenty of land here on the farm to pitch our booths and to celebrate from a distance. The love of Yisrael is Echad, no matter where our flesh resides. We berach Yah for that. You may not hear from us often, Ma'ach, we want you to know that all the messages Yah has placed upon you to give have been faithfully received on this end. You are truly appreciated as a fellow servant of Yah, and much achava comes from our humble abode to you and yours. With much shalom and hallelujah in Yeshua HaMashiach. Greetings from our Ach Frank and his Isha Yachanan, Brother John from the mountains of West Virginia. What a beautiful expression of the Eduth of Almighty Yah that he grants unto Yisrael. Here is one from a precious Achot. She writes, Reach David and Teshua community. May the blessings and the hava of Yah be with you on his Kodesh day. I am sorry that I cannot be there at this very special time in body, but I certainly will be listening and watching the live broadcast if it is provided. Since last year, I have not found a place where I can gather and join with the Ach and the Echut in truth. So long for that very, very much, but Yahweh has provided that through this ministry, and I just cannot thank him enough for you all. You know, I never really understood or grasped what the Feast of Trumpets symbolized. But after the reading, the information you provide on the website, you have made it very clear and simple what his feast is all about. It is a very serious time because Yahweh is giving us this time to prepare ourselves as his bride for Yeshua HaMashiach return. I knew in the past it was very important to recognize it as part of the Torah, but I did not know that it could be part of our eternal salvation. At this time, I feel a deep sadness because everyone in my house is going in different directions. My sons went out to work today. My daughter went to school, even though I told them this is the Feast of HaShabbat, and we should not work or do usual activities on the day. But they did not hearken. They did not listen. Also, for the last 8 months, my circumstance has been somewhat difficult. She talks about things that have arisen, but yet Yah has given her strength and all of that. She concludes that I will do my part as best I can. I have prepared a wonderful feast for us to partake of, even though we're not all in the same Ruach. I will cherish this special time that Yah has provided. And she ends this with a salutation, Shalom, Sister Anna, that even in the midst of great trials and agonies, she holds fast to the Torah of Yah, and that is vitally important for us Yisrael. Here is one, an Ach in Yisrael, our Ach. He writes unto us here. He greets us, Shalom Ach Yisrael. I recently ran across your radio program, and I must say I loved it so much. You have a fire, the Ruach, moving inside of you so much that you are unapologetically preaching the Torah. I have been listening to different Torah teachers for some time. Over my lifespan, and you have a different approach than any other I have ever heard. I will pause there and inject. You hear the simple teaching of Torah that is not complex. It is easy to understand, to digest, to understand the parameter whereby Yisrael, a nation, must walk within to comply with all that he commands us. And so the simplicity of his truth has opened up his uzen that he may hear not only with his ears, but he will hear with his ayin, with the mind of Yeshua. So there is nothing to contribute unto me It is to contribute unto the Ruach of Yah, how he opens the heart of Yisrael to hear what he speaks. Quote, I just wanted to let you know that Yah has you reaching other people, and we love your zeal. I am sharing your sight. It is our sight, Yisrael. We have no pattern on that at all. He is sharing the sight with others. He says here, as he quotes, I will pray for Teshua, the congregation there, and rejoice. I will allow the Shimcha of Yah, the excitement of Torah, and rejoice that they have someone who Yah has blessed so much to teach them. I appreciate that. I will read that the way he said it. It was one thing that even in the state of my ignorance and evangelist Hartsfield, I appreciated everything that he directed me to in Torah. Even though we both were ignorant, I trusted what he said. I trusted his labor and his faithfulness. And this is a generation that do not appreciate Yah, because we want our own type of synthetic hybrid religious type of service teachings that are appropriate or pleasing to our flesh. I will never on my deathbed concede to any of us in that fashion. And I began here because I am the teacher and I must first be the partaker. I will never. It is one of my prayers often to Yah. I will say to him, kill me. I mean it, Yah. Don't allow me to have or to cause a disdain for your name. I'm not afraid to say that. Kill me, Yah. I mean it. Don't allow me to do something that would impede the heart of Yisrael. Take me out today. I mean it. Now that I'm not playing with. And I am not afraid to say it. And I mean it from the depths of whatever river of resources from Elev that he has put in me. I mean that. Kill me, Yah. Take me out now. I mean it. Again, I will pray for the congregation and rejoice that they have someone who Yah has blessed so much to teach them. I would love to be able to assemble with your congregation if I ever make it down that way. Keep up the righteous work and do not change your delivery of the messages. It's the fire of Almighty Yah. May you and yours be blessed by Almighty Yahuwah, Barach Chama, Bashem Yahuwah, Shalom. And this is from our brother Grant, a brother in Yisrael. So we do Barach Yah for the Eduot, the testimonies of his power to refresh, to open up the wisdom of his people, that they will know what is of Yah and what is not of Yah, that they have understanding to discern. And that is what we need, Yisrael. Although I began the teaching last week on the two witnesses of Yah, the Shanaim, Eid, we must have the ability to know whether they are of Yah, that we will not oppose the works of the witnesses, or whether this is the hand of Hashatan. And our minds have been trained in the natural realm to receive everything that is of darkness. But that which brings light It is one thing that light does when it enters in. The first thing that it does, it reveals the dark mysteries of our own hearts, the works that are conjured by our flesh, the appetite that is driven by a mind that is diametrically opposed to the mind of Yeshua HaMashiach. That's why we delight in things that are sensual, things that are earthly, things that are wicked. We don't delight in the Torah of Yah. And so Yah brings us to a time where we must sit in our sakh or our sackcloth to this time of Kippurah, Yom Kippurah, a time that his chafa, the atonement of Yeshua, would cover our sins and wash away the blight of wickedness that has infested our minds, our activities, our actions, our deeds, that we literally think within ourselves that we are right. Even our wickedness is not exposed because there is no light. When the awe of Yeshua came into the world, men hated it because their deeds were evil and their deeds were full of darkness. That is why this is a nation that despises the truth of Yah. And so we as a people, when we hear when he speaks to us, because darkness overshadows us, we don't delight or rejoice in the Torah of Yah, but we take great pleasure in some of the most frivolous, foolish activities that don't mean a damn thing. We take consolation in that. But when it comes to Yah and hearing Jushemach, a love that is faithful in obedience, that is complicit or that will act according to what is commanded, it creates this discomfort. We don't like that. We don't want him to speak to the mysteries of our own hearts. So he brings us to a time like this to afflict, to cause this flesh to be afflicted. It is vitally important that we understand that we need the dam of Yeshua HaMashiach, and it is most applicable to the redeemed remnant of Israel, just the faithful few. And this time and season that we are in, it is vitally important because we don't discern it through the barringers of the flesh, but through the mind, through the ruach of Yeshua HaMashiach. And then once we understand the beauty of that, we understand the power of Yeshua HaMashiach. If we don't understand that, we will not understand the power of the works in this corrupt thing we call flesh to bring about the fullness of the Torah power unto Yisrael. That the song that we sing, we certainly can do all things through Yah. By the power of Yeshua HaMashiach that gives us strength of knowledge of Torah. And if we don't have that, we're not going to be able to do those things. Hallelujah. We need the kafa of Yah, the covering. And that covering is Yeshua HaMashiach. There is nothing else that covers the sins of Yisrael. As he cast them as far as the east, it's from the west. And it is the dam of Yeshua, that kafa, that covers the sins. That the sins do not cover us. There are acts of blatant defiance of Torah that we transgress. Then they are covered by the dam of Yeshua, as it was with Aharon for this time, this season, to make sure that Israel But the offering of the bullock was covered by the dam. The song says it still takes the dam. It still takes the blood. It still takes the blood. From the Bereshits with Atom, he covered them with the clothing of Sadiq, of his righteousness. And it took the blood then, the shedding of blood. Yah has not changed. It still takes the dam, the shedding of blood. He is the same Yisrael, and he does not change at all. I want to begin here at the altar, as we are gathered at the altar of Almighty Yah on this great day, this Day of Atonement. I want to begin here as we present the offering that is vitally important, the fragrance that flow from our bosom. It has to be a sweet fragrance. It cannot be this vile stench that we allow to flow in us, because our guts are rotten with sin. You cannot pass sin out. You cannot eradicate sin, my friends. It must be purged by the power of the hearing of Torah. Yeah. And if Yah does not open your zin, your ears, your mind, your heart to receive, he intends for it to stay intact. He has no purpose to deliver you at all. He is going to damn us into the abyss of darkness, where the mind shall cry, yet there is no relief of the agony of the great pain of affliction. So he commands us to afflict ourselves today, that we understand the value and the importance of obeying every word that he speaks. I began here in the book of Shemoth, in the book of Exodus. Shemoth, Exodus chapter 30 and verse 8. It gives us, beginning at verse 1, because of time today, I want to begin here at verse 8. And it gives us the process of Aharon as he offers unto Almighty Yah for the atonement, the chafa, of the sins of Yisrael. And it speaks so clearly here in the book of Exodus chapter 30, verse 8. And when Aharon lights the near, when he lights the menorah, and that is what the Torah of Yah does, the hearing of the Torah, it lights the menorah, the near, the lights. The seven re'achim of Yah shall come alive in us, Yisrael. Ruach of fear of Yah, the Ruach HaKodesh, the Ruach of understanding, the Ruach of knowledge, the Ruach of wisdom, it shall come alive in us. And so the hearing of the Torah shall cause the knee of the lamp, the witness of the power of the testimony of Yahshua to come alive. So when we hear the Torah, it's a great witness of what he has written in our bosom. He said, when he lights the lamp at evening, he shall burn incense upon it. Yah says that the burning of this incense, it is a perpetual or a tomim. It is a continuously, without ceasing. It never ceases. So when he lights the incense, and that is the incense of the fragrance of Yahshua, the power of that testimony. We cannot let that go out, the fragrance of that. He is the sweet-smelling fragrance of offering for our sins. And so we must offer up the fragrance of that testimony unto Yah, that it may be well-pleasing to his nostrils, that he may delight in the fragrance that omits from Yisrael, his people. It shall be perpetual incense before Yah. He says, throughout your generation, your habitation, your dwelling, throughout all generations this shall persist. Can we turn the light of his testimony off today? Or shall it persist continuously? That we pass the light down to our sons and our daughters and those that should come after us. So the right of Aharon, the actions, they did not cease. It is a perpetual, it is a li'ulam, it is continuous. It has no cessation. It doesn't stop. Yah says you should offer no strange in verse 9. You should offer no strange incense, ketereth. You should offer no strange incense, no perfume, no fragrance. At times we come before Yah, we know that our bosom is full of stench. We stink with the fragrance of sin. Our hands are dirty and filthy. Our hands are cruddy and wicked. And our hands are not clean to offer unto him a living offering from the depths of our bosom of Todah. So we can't do it. It is a false action of pretense. Offer no strange incense thereon. He said, nor any burnt offering, sacrifices, nor meat offering. Neither shall you drink or pour drink offering upon it. And this is what he states in verse 10. He says, and Aharon, Yoshua the High Kohen, after the order of Melchizedek, who had no begotten, in the quarrels of our knowledge of what is written in the writings of Torah. And Aharon shall make an atonement, a kafah, a covering, that which covers us, that which hides the very tainted and the very blotted flesh of the garment that we are wearing. We must hate the garment that has been spotted by the actions, the activities of the natural carnal man. And then Aharon shall make an atonement, the chafa, upon the horn. The horn represents the strength of the high place of Yah. We should always make the offering of Yah from our leba, because it is our minds that is the strongest attribute of us. And that is what the horn represents. The place whereby the cry of Yah, it is the shofar, the warning, the sound, a preparation, and to make oneself ready, yeah? That one can receive what Yah speaks. That is why we must sound the shofar. Cry aloud. Lift up your voice like the shofar. He must do it upon the horn of the altar. He must do it once in a year, in this time. In this time, he did it. This time is a reminder of the horn of the strength of Yah, Yeshua, as he makes atonement for our filthy, most damnable, unclean, corrupt ways continuously before the Ponim, the face, and the presence of Almighty Yah. And when we understand this day, we will understand the purpose of Yeshua, the horn of the strength of Yah, and we will rejoice continuously. There shall be a continuous, perpetual fragrance of perfume and incense that goes up before Yah. And what goes up before him is the stench of our folly and our sin, our wickedness, our unclean activities, our defiance of what he commands us. That is the prototype of the time that we're in as we come to a day like this, to a moel, to understand the value and the importance of it, that it is a daily process for us. It is a Shabbaton, it is a time of rest in Yeshua every day. that we take our rest, our shofats, that we rest in the comfort of the living Torah that is in us, Yisrael. He says, you shall do it once a year with the dam of the sin offering of the kafah, the atonements. Once in a year shall he make kafah atonement upon it. Again, he reminds us throughout your generation. You all hear that? He says, because it is most kodesh unto Yah. This is a time that is kodesh unto Yah. And we cannot, Yisrael, forsake this assembly and gathering of Yisrael. Because when you see my wickedness and my sins and the works of Yahshua, it caused you to rejoice greatly with great fatness. And when I see that one sin and that one see that one sin and that one see that one sin, they all reflect back on them. If it had not been for Yah on my side, tell me through the course of this year, where would I be? And so it is a delight to come into his presence and you offer up a fragrance that is so pure and that it project you like a projectile that you go from this day as we enter into tabernacle or sukkah, as you sleep in your booth with great appreciation for what Yah has done in this natural biological tabernacle. You offering up the offerings of Ishua, the fire of great delight that pleases the bosom of Almighty Yah. Once a year, that this must be offered for the sins as a chafah for Yisrael. And once it is offered, the fragrance of the burnt offering, although it's a stench to the natural nostril, it is the beauty of fragrance to Yah. And the reason why is because we have obliged him in what pleases him. You may not see the pleasure, but he wants to see the obedience of faith, Emunah. Because without Emunah, you cannot please him. And this most twisted, damnable drugstore type thing that they're selling today as Emunah, it is a damnable, twisted delusion out of the gates of hell. It has come from the depths of the heart of HaShatan, because it does not create any delight in the Torah of Yah at all. I don't give a damn what the world says. And that is the truth. There must be a perpetual burning of fire in us. And that the near the lamp of Yah must be lit every evening. And so when you rise in the morning, the light is still bright. And as the oil begins to burn and dissipate, at the close of the evening, you put the oil in. As the five wise and the five foolish, you notice that they had gone to bed. It was a night season, and them in bed represent the night season that is upon us. And when they heard the sound of the shofar, they all arose to trim their near. For the Torah of Yah is a lamp. That's what it is. Unto Yisrael, it is a light. Unto our Yelach, the way that the Torah commands us to walk. And yet the five foolish had no oil. They did not trim their lantern that evening. And so Yah gives us a day to trim our near. On this atoma to rekindle, to revive, to resuscitate the hidden life of the testimony of Yeshua in us. And we began to speak forthrightly with the great sweet fragrance of the words that flow from our bosom. And not this most damnable delusion of fleshly appeasing. We must speak by the Torah of Yah. So as we come to this day, Yisrael, it is of great importance and great beauty. As the Baf said, because of the simplicity of the teaching of the Mo'adem, I have learned to appreciate the meaning and the purpose behind that. We do berach arach ach Simeon and ach Yabin for their diligence, for getting those things on the website for Yah's people. That is a vital effort. You don't have to stand here and do that. This, what I'm doing, what they are doing, and what Arach Simeon is doing, then Arachot Anna would have not heard. Our precious Beth there in the island of Granada would not have heard. Our precious friends there, Yachachan and his Isha, as I have read her testimony before, that when she first listened to the messages coming from here, it was like a wild thing. And yet her ears were drawn back. I talked with my Ach Thomas Lowe there in Memphis. There was one that called him and said, I don't like the way the man talked. I say, my Ach is not the phonics of the sounding of my words. It is just the truth he doesn't like. And you tell him that if he wants to debate, I will help him set up a meeting, and I will come to Memphis, Tennessee, and I will declare the emets of Yah. Hallelujah. This is perpetual. The reading of Weira, chapter 23, beginning in verse 26. The Torah says, and Yah spoke unto Moshe, saying, his Daba was revealed unto Moshe by the hearing of his ears. He heard it vocally from the call, the voice, the entirety of Yah's power, whom he is. He spoke unto him, and he spoke precisely. He commands us in the month of Tishri. I know in the Gregorian, in the month of September to October, it is that time of the year that the Gregorian calls September or October. But Yah says it is Tishri. And he gives us precisely, he says, as also on the 10th day, you cannot deny that. He says, of the Shebi, of the seventh month, of the Kadosh, of the Kodash month, he said, there shall be a Yom HaKippurah. There shall be a time of atonement. It shall be a time of reminder of what I wrote and spoke to you, Moshe, from the beginning. He says, it shall be a Nikra Chodash to you, and you shall afflict your nefesh. You shall humble yourself, you shall deny the will and the purpose of our flesh. Our flesh is a filthy thing. As far as my flesh, there is no tough thing that dwells in your flesh. In the fleshly heart, it is deceitful above all things, and it is desperately wicked. That's what we must let. The heart of Yeshua, the same one. It must be in us, Yisrael. You shall afflict your nefesh, and offer an offering made by fire unto Yah. It must be a testimony, a fragrance. As they would sing in the old days, He's sweet, I know. Yes, He is sweet, I know. And the storm clouds may rise. The strong winds may blow the winds of terror. The winds of agony, our enemies rise up against us. But I will tell the Olam, the Melechim, and the messengers of Yah, and the nations of the earth, that not only have I found, but I Yada, I have found my Yoshach, because He found me in the midst of the dire mess of sin and every kind of corruption. It was the power of His Torah that redeemed me. It released me from the prison of the shackles of the chains of pain and agony of my love, that I can have confidence and trust in Him. And so He gives us instructions that that the mind, the natural mind, will not strive to obey it, but we shall by the Ruach, because we're the sons of Yah, and we're led by the Ruach of Almighty Yah. He tells us in the 10th day. He tells us when the 10th day began, at the eve of the 9th. He said, we began, He says, in the 10th day of the same month, we shall make this Kippurah unto Yah. And He tells us here, quite frankly, in verse 29, He says, for any nefesh, any being, as we would say, any soul, any living substance of life, anything that has the fullness of the breath of Yah in it. This is what He says. This is not for the heathens. He says, and if for any nephesh it be that shall not afflict himself, He says, in the same day, in the hour, in the same day, He says, he shall be karath. Yah says, I will exterminate that one. I will cut him off. I don't care who he is. What a man, what a daughter, what a bath, what an ish, when a man reaches the age of maturity, and he hears this as you as parents have taught them, and if they do not obey, then they shall be cut off from the covenant blessings of Yah. And that's why the enemy has imposed this damnable thing through Christendom, to tell them to ask and to pray to give. You get all you want. It is nothing but one of the most damnable, twisted Ponzi schemes you ever want to be a partaker of. Yah will put it in the bosom of a man to give. The reason those do not give, because Yah is not putting a damn thing in their wicked bosoms. I will, my friend. They have no desire. I was speaking to the Zachin on the first day. He said to me, you know, my desire, my heart desire to do more, because I understand. I said to him, man, if you did give one penny, just your present means more to me than all the money in the world. It does. It does. He says, I know, Re'ach, but my passion is to do more and to, I know what it takes. I understand. And I know you will do right. I said, I will. And then he says, it makes no difference, because as I give it unto Yah, you are accountable. And again I replied, my friend, what you do is more than enough. It is so much. Just your presence alone is of great value. Is not the presence of Yahshua of great value? Is not great is he that is in me? Is not Yahshua in me? Just the presence of his witness, to witness what is in me, that is enough. Because darkness and light cannot fellowship together. There's no strength unto either one. He said, if one does not apply to my instructions, he shall be karath, eliminated, off from among his people. And again, he says in verse 30, and whatsoever nephesh, whomever it is that day does any work, in the same day he commands us not to do any laborious work. Don't labor to feed the voracity and the ferociousness of our flesh and folly and things that do not pertain to Yah. Yah said, don't even give time to that. Don't labor to please your flesh. Don't labor to satisfy your flesh. Don't labor in those things. If you do not impel it and destroy the affections and the lust of your flesh, then he's going to destroy us. Do no servile work in that day. He says that now that individual that does work in that day, he says, I will abat. I will kill him like you kill and cut off a damn snake's head. Yah says, I will destroy from among the people. He is saying, in the essence, when he uses the word abad, he said, I will make assessment. He said, I will judge that matter. I don't need the Kohan. I will judge it. And that is what Yah's doing, because people will not abide in the commands and oblige him. He is judging them according to his heart, and he is killing them dead. There is no life in them. There's no will. There's no substance of his desire. No passion at all for Yah. They have this false pretense. They have a form of what is right to them, but they deny Torah. And these are some of the most damned of wicked people. You're supposed to be a man of God, damn gods. I'm a messenger of Yah. The revelation of Yeshua. If your demand speaks not according to the Torah and the eduth of Yah, the testimony of Yeshua, is it because there is no awe, there is no life, there is no witness of Yeshua's testimony in him? I don't care who the man is. If one speaks not according to that protocol, he's a damn liar. And he's full of death. Yah says, do no servile. Don't labor. Labor and serve your flesh. He said, because when you do, I am offended. As I read in the book of Shemoth, it says that this time was Chodesh unto Yah. Yah says here in Leviticus, with Yirah, it is Chodesh unto us, isn't it? And so it should be a set apart time that is set apart to reverence Almighty Yah by the power of the sweet fragrance of Yeshua, that testimony. Verse 31 of Yirah 23, you shall do no matter of work. Yah says it shall be a hukah, it shall be an ordinance. It is what I have prescribed by my own heart. Can our heart overpower the love of Yah? And so that is what he says. This is my hukah. It is my hukah. It is my hukmah. He said, this is what I prescribe out of my heart. He said, it is forever. Liolam, olam, liolam viat. It is perpetual. Ponim. It is forever. It never ceases. He said, throughout your generations, in all of your dwellings, in all of your dwellings, it is as it was then, it shall be today. And he concludes here, it shall be to you. It's my pleasure, but to you, it shall be a Shabbat Shabbaton, a time of rest, delighting and rejoicing in Yeshua. And again, he says, and you shall afflict your nephesh. He tells us when to afflict it. He says, in the ninth day, yesterday, began the ninth day. That was the ninth day of Yah's month. His Kodash. He says, in the ninth day of the month, he tells us when. At Ebreb. When the sun goes down. The passing, that's what Ebreb is. Ebreb is when the sun goes down. When darkness before. He says, at evening. From evening to evening. Is not that not simple? So these damnable liars say that the Shabbat doesn't begin in the evening. They're full of their own dung. They're damn liars. Is this not precise? It takes no interpretation of that. It takes a faithful obedience. He tells us when. From evening until evening. From Ebreb, from that evening, when the sun goes out, and that is what the word Ebreb means. Ebreb. It means the going down of the sun, when darkness began to fall, when there's a cessation of lights. It is yes. He says, from the going down of the sun to the going down of the same, as we would say, the name of Yah should be honored and praised. He says, when that happens, he tells us this. He gives us vital instructions. He said, you shall Shabbat, celebrate, to dance, to rejoice. This should be an activity daily. He brings us to a time on the seventh day of the week that we should have a Shabbat. We shall celebrate. I will celebrate, sing unto Yahweh. I will celebrate Yeshua. That's what we celebrate. We celebrate that testimony, that atonement, that kafar. The covering of our damnable wicked sins. That's what we said. That's why we ought to be glad. That's why we come in the Yasbeit. We come with our hands lifted and our voices crying hallelujah. We don't come before him like a damn dead thing. We have the living substance of Torah. He means what he says. That's why he says it, because he means it. He said, I will kill them all. I will abad. I will cut them off. I will cut off. I will destroy them. This is the Abba we serve, Yisrael. So he gives us the guidance, the statutes, the limitation, the hukah, as to his moed, doesn't he? And it's simple to obey. As I said to you, you that are listening, and I promise you this, I have many, many messages to teach. I cannot teach them all because I'm constantly, by the Ruach, developing messages. And I awakened this morning, this on my left, and I knew this what Yah wanted today. But I promise you all, after the feast days are over, I will do a teaching that is so precise, so elementary, that we all will say, what a fool I've been not to understand the simplicity of Yah's instructions. It was only because no one defined unto me the meaning of the words. And if we don't think that definition or definitive is not important, we are damn fools. And we need men that would take the scholastic approach to study the Torah, not read the book, man. But to study to lehach as you labor, man. You will study the way you labor. Listen, I study the way I work. And I'm a Tasmanian beast when it comes to that. I am. I'm not boasting in any damn flesh. And we must lehach, study to show ourselves acceptable unto Yah as the workman. That when you present unto me, you will not be ashamed. Don't boast in your flesh and think you have done something that is excellent, man. I want your teaching to challenge the simplicity of my heart. I want your teaching to challenge the simplicity of my knowledge. That's what I want, Yisrael. I don't care how simple it sounds, but make sure it has depth of utterance when we talk, all right? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. This is a hard saying. You must eat my flesh and drink my dumb. This is a hard saying. And then the 5,000, they turn and walk no more with him. Why is it hard? Because we are transgressors. We are willing. The way of a transgressor, his ways, his derech, his heart. But the way of Yah, the light of his Torah, the light of Yahshua, shines daily. You can't see where you're placing your feet. In darkness, you cannot. Hallelujah. So he said, we shall celebrate. Is the speech of Yah everlasting? Does he change? So we must celebrate like he says. We must shabbath. Sing unto Yahweh a new song. We must shabbath. We must celebrate this time and this season. And it is a perpetual celebration. That the next day, the next day, the next day, 1 week, 2 weeks, 1 month, 3 months, 5 months, 1 year, the fire. So we come back to Yah this time next year. The fire is even more of an infernal of fire. Look where Yah brought me from. You know he brought me from a mighty war. A mighty, mighty long way. Oh, look where, oh, yeah, and brought me from. That's why they could sing the song 15, 20 minutes. Because it would ignite the fire in them. We need oil in us, Yisra'el. We need the oil of truth. We need the true witness of Yah. That's the oil of Yah. We need the true witness of Yah. The Ruach HaKodesh doesn't come and testify himself. He testifies what has been said. We need the true witness of Yah, us, Yisra'el. Yeah. We've allowed so much dung in us. There's no fervent fire, and there's a stench that flows from us. I want a sweet fragrance to flow from us. Hallelujah. Is this vital to us? It is very vital. Yochanan, as he writes unto Yisra'el scattered about, in 1 John here, 1 Yochanan, F. Yochanan, 1 John chapter 2, verse 1. He says unto them as the Shlishach, he directs us to the power of the atonement. That's all right. Lift your hands, little one. The atonement of Yahshua. And he directs us to that kafar to show us the ability of Torah to assist, to help, to give power to overcome our sinful nature. He says, my taf, my little bane, my little children, he said, these things I write unto you that you sin not. As Azachin, Rameyah Yisra'el brought out unto us that there is no perpetual desire to sin. When you hear the Torah, don't harden your heart. Just obey that you sin not. And if any of us sin, any man sin, he said we have an advocate, a khafa, an atonement, an advocate with the Abba. He identifies who he is, Yahshua HaMashiach. He is the righteousness of Yah. He is our advocate. He is what speaks to Yah. Our prayers are interpreted by what he speaks, what his Sadiq speaks unto Yah. That's why we do all things in the power of that name, Yahshua. We do all things through Yahshua HaMashiach. For his testimony is the power of Yah that gives us strength. And without that testimony, we have no strength. That's why Yisra'el will offer up the offerings and they sin willfully against Yah. And we don't have the power of that because we continue to sin. So I write that you sin not as the breath of the Zachin spoke unto us that we do not blatantly defy what Yah commands. And he himself, Yahshua, he is the atonement, the propitiation. He is the offering. He is the complete sin offerings. And the word propitiation in its purest form, it means this. Come and tell us the word propitiation. If you never remember anything, remember this. I know what we have been taught. But we need men to go beyond the surface of things. But the word perpetuation, it means in the Arabic, even in the Latin, as I discovered in my ignorance of definitives of words, it means this. It means this. This is the crux of it. Can I tell us? It is to restore the friendship. That is what it means. Yeshua said, I call you no more abbots, but I call you friends. For friend knows not, the servant knows not what the master does. I restore the friendship of Yah. That is the true definitive of perpetuation. To restore the friendship of Yah to Yisrael. To restore the friendship of Yisrael unto Omariah, because we are his friends. That's why he tells us all things. That's why he reveals all things unto us, because we're his friends. So he is our propitiator. He is the one that restores our friendship unto Yah. Isn't that beautiful? Oh, that's enough to make me rejoice. I don't want to be the friend of the gods. I want to be the friend of Yah. I don't want the friendship of the gods. I want the friendship of Almighty Yah and Yeshua. So we know that Yeshua is our propitiation. He is the atonement. He is the kafar for our sins. And not only our sins, but also the sins of the whole earth. Well, I know what Christian I'm preach. He wants everyone to be saved. No, that's not what he's implying. Yisrael has been scattered to the four corners of the earth. If Yah shall grant us, my Zachin, next year, tabernacle, the theme shall be the message to the four corners of the earth. You remind me of that. Hallelujah. He is speaking of a people that have been scattered globally to the four corners of the earth. The language has been marred by idiom and idolatrous type of elements that when they hear the name of Yah, they hear truth, they will not even know it. And we have become immersed into this Gentile society, a heathenistic way, a way that the flesh promotes and not what Torah promotes. Not only for you that are with me, not only for you that hear my voice, is what Yah Kahan is saying, but it's for Yisrael, for the house of Yehuda, is for the house of Ephraim. It's for Yah's people, scattered. You're not going to identify them by the form of the pigmentation of the skin. It has to be something written in their bosom. It has to be a testimony when they hear that name. When they hear the truth, they shout, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, oh, hallelujah, they shout that. You understand, Yisrael? They shout from the depths of the volume of their being, and they turn to Yah for the testimony of Yeshua. Without that testimony, there is no Yashak for Yisrael. Hallelujah. And not only for us, but for the sins of the whole of Yisrael, the nation of his people. Listen to this in verse 3. As he direct our knowledge and our attention to understand that the obedience or the hearing of Torah, it produced the obedience unto Yah, and it caused us to love Yisrael, the Yisraelites. And hereby, we do know that we yada, this is how we yada, we know him. If we keep his mitzvah. Did I not read from the book of Weyira, the mitzvah, the instructions, the command of this day that Yah grants unto us? That we must afflict our nefesh, we must humble ourselves, we must not labor to appease our flesh, that it may promote this perpetual desire and passion for Almighty Yah. And the testimony is alive in us, Yisrael. He said, those that keep my mitzvah. You are a liar to say you love Yah. You can love God. You can love Jesus. You can love Baal. But you are a liar if you do not keep the commandments of Almighty Yah. For that is a true test of our faithfulness and our discipleship unto Yeshua HaMashiach. That we keep the commands. Don't tell me, my friend, when you say that this command here, that you do not remember the Shabbat and keep it kadosh, you are a damn liar. When you create a God before him, an image of something that is full of deceit, when you bow down to gods and things and all kinds of foreign elements of your mind that you create, when you take the name of Yah and says it is Shav, you are a damn liar. I don't give a damn how old you are, how young you are. And that's the truth. That's mama. It doesn't mean a damn thing to Yah. That's your mama. But she is not a mother unto Yisrael. She doesn't birth within Bath Yisrael the beauty of Yah's testimony, that they may learn and loving their ish, that it shows and presents unto the ish the fervent of Yah's love. And then the ish understand the beauty of Yahshua's love, that he governs his house according to that love, according to Torah, the commands of Yah. Our houses are governed by some ideology that is so damn twisted and false. We are crippled and diseased. Our minds are twisted from darkness. And that is the truth. Hallelujah. He that says, I yada him, and keep not his mitzvah, is a liar. If we don't keep atonement, but yet you find some way to work your damn Christmas in, your damn hog day Thanksgiving, talk to me, man. You have this tingling sensation around these most damnable pagan God days that is imaginable. When it comes to Yah's days, you say you don't have to do it. You got this damn teaching out here, and I say it again, the person that is the leader of what they call Israelite or Yisraelite heritage, he wrote an article that says you don't have to keep the feast days unless you're in Yerushalayim. So I, as he welcomed the rebuttal, I did. I've written the cowardly man, I hope someone hears me, and write to him and said, that man, he knows me, he knows of me. I wrote the cowardly man and he will not respond. Twice. I think that that is somewhat of a kind of an honesty and integrity. He will not respond because his teaching is based upon lies. It's amazing that these men will say, Yah showed me that he's a damn liar. That was taught before he was ever born. There were men teaching that before he was ever born. Our minds, our identity is always shaped by what we hear. This damn wicked generation wants to think that they have something of a multitude that's greater than someone else. They're damn liars. Everything we do has been formulated and shaped by what we have heard, what we've been taught. I'm not the inventor of anything. Neither are you. So you have no pattern when it comes to this. And they're damn liars. Yah spoke to me. Well, I would think that Yahshua would speak to you. I would think the living Torah would speak to you. And they would say, oh, Yah spoke to me. You damn liars, all of you. You damn liars. Yochanan said, a man said that he loves Yah and he keeps not his Torah. That's what speaks to us, his mitzvah. He is a liar. He is a liar. And he said the Torah, the truth is not in him. He's a damn liar. Did I begin this from Torah? He says the truth. HaTorah is not in him. The truth of Yah is not in him. He goes on to say here, but whosoever shema or keep his daba, truly, whosoever got the Torah of Yah, truly the Ahava of Yah is tomim, perfected. It is complete. It is whole in him. Hereby yada we that we are in him. This is how we know we're in him. Because we oblige him in what he commands us to do. This is the day that Yah commands. This truth shall be scattered throughout the four corners of the earth. We honor the mu'adim of Yah. We keep them. We guard them. We shema. We protect them. We preserve them. We teach our sons and our daughters that they may perfect the order of the activities. They celebrate. They shabbat. That they may understand the beauty of the purpose. Do not parents and our parents taught us one of the most damnable dysfunctional activities upon the face of the earth to keep Christmas? Did not they teach us? Did not we institute those rituals in our children? The damn pagan tree, the damn light, the gifts, the drinking. Come on, Yisraya. You're not talking to a damn fool now. I'm an ignorant man, but I'm not a damn fool. Sure we did. And so we train our children in the way that they shall go, and they shall not depart from Torah. Can Yah lie? All right then. We've done a poor job on training. Just say we've done a poor job. Hallelujah. That's all it is. You can't blame nobody but yourself. He goes on to say that here in verse 6, he that says he abides or stays in Yah should himself also walk even as Yahshua walked. We say we're in Yah, we should walk as Yahshua. Did Yahshua come to dismantle the feast days, the Mo'adim of Yah? Nowhere. He kept them in Yerushalayim. Three times a year, the men, the Ach, had to go to Yerushalayim. Pesach, Sho'ud Chvach, and Tabernacle. They would bring their booths, and they would dwell there in the city. They would hear the reading of the Torah, and then they would celebrate the ingathering to dance and to eat and to offer up offerings of Yah's abundance. You find these gatherings today are full of folly. The man that came last year, as he watched my actions right here, as I said to two, get off these grounds. The man that said he will let no one come between us, this most damnable, effeminate generation, yet he did that. You understand? These are weak men. They have not the strength and the character of Yah. As in the days they would say they talking, saying much and saying nothing. Talking loud and saying nothing. You got that gap, man, but you're not saying anything. The true test is in the putting. Your actions, man. Come on, Yisrael. There must be messages among us that's real. Because you are not real, that doesn't mean that there are those that are not real. Because you don't know how to abide in your home and take care of your husband, that doesn't mean that there are women that don't know how to. Because you don't know how to love your wife as your command, that doesn't mean that there are men that do not know how to. Because you don't know how to care for your home, that doesn't mean that there are men that do not know how to do that. This is a damn twisted generation. Because you're a thief, that doesn't mean I'm a thief. Because you lie, that doesn't mean I lie. Because your house is filthy, that doesn't mean her house is filthy. Talk to me. I'm going to finish this today. It's not much, but that's all right. We got another 50 minutes, all right? That's right. We keep you in here because if you go home, the only thing you're going to think about that belly. All right, how about that? So let me fill your belly with 12 things, the sweet things of Yah. I eat a piece of cornbread, and that bread we had the other day, the last days of bread. Who baked that bread yesterday? Let me see your heart. Don't bake no bread like that. Bread runs you crazy. Can't get enough of that. Come on, don't bake that bread here. I'm commanding you to bake it for the people, but don't bake me no bread like that. Just like that. Don't change nothing. Bread runs you crazy. Then I say to myself, why am I Ishmael? Bring me some of this and put it back. Just hide it. Don't worry about it. I'll eat it. Hallelujah. And so I give you bread like that. How about that? Sweet bread. Beautiful breads. Manna. You don't even know what it is. Just eat it. When it gets down to the depths of your belly, it will be sweet. It will satisfy the palates. Hallelujah. Yokohan says, Ark, brothers, I write no new commandment, mitzvah, to you. He said, but an old mitzvah, Yokohan, 1 Yokohan 2:7, which you had from the beginning. The old mitzvah is the word which you have heard from the Bereshit. In the beginning, Yah created. In the beginning of us, He created the testimony in us. In the beginning, Yisrael, Yah. He is the one that creates Bara by His power, by His word. It is His word that creates Yeshua in us. It is the hearing of Torah that creates the passion and the desire in us. We shut our ears from hearing. We close our ears. Then what is going to be created in us is what we hear. We hear lies. We create lies. We hear folly. We walk in folly. Your abode, your dwelling is among heathens. You're going to act like a damn heathen. But you will justify your ignorant, wicked ways, Yisrael. He goes on to say, again, a new mitzvah I write to you. Which thing is batak, is true, in Him, in Yah, in you. If you are in Him, He is in you, then what you do is of the truth because it testifies of Yah. Because the darkness is past and the true light now shines. The Torah shines now. The Torah is a light unto our pathway. It is a lamp unto our feet. Yeshua now shines. He shines in the pathway of this Kippurah, this young Kippurah, that we understand the beauty of it and we keep it according to the Ruach of Yah. We offer the offerings. We come, we afflict, we cause this old flesh, we cause it to soom, to fast. Yah commands us to do it. It is so vitally important unto Him. He is showing us that we don't live by the dictates and the commands of our flesh. That's why we're in the shape we're in. We're in the shape mentally and spiritually and the shape in our physical being because we live by one of the most damnable, volatile, corrupt things. And that is a mind that is created in the stoneness of one's will. Everything that happens unto us because we are adamant in our will. We must do all things to please Him. Yeah. That's what the word will is. If it be your will, we say that. But if it's your hafitz, that's what will is. Hafitz, hafitz. If it's your pleasure, if it's your desire, if it's what pleases you. As the old ones will say, if it's Yah's will, I'll come. And so you will know it's Yah's will because if it pleases Him, It will put pleasure in your heart to go. People think that they have to get this some kind of telepathy, this type of spiritual gyration, this epiphany to move. No, I say, my ach, if it's Yah's will, I will come. If it pleases Yah, if we delight ourselves in Yah, He will give us the desires of our heart. What desire His heart pleasure, He will cause us to have pleasure in it. If we have a brother that is far and to visit that Akka, you know that's the pleasing of Yah's bosom. Then we go. We don't have to look for a sign. I don't need no sign. Hallelujah. Yahshua is my sign. That's enough for me. As old folks would say, quote, that's good enough for me, unquote. He said it, that's tough enough for me. He said that this true light might shine. Verse 9, he that says he is in the light and his son, his ach, is in darkness even unto now. You say you love Yah, you're walking in the light, and you despise your ach. You forsake the assembly of fellowship. There are individuals that save their vacation time to go to a damn wicked family reunion. And yet they will not come to the family reunion that Yah commands. That we sleep in our booth, but some old wicked whore's daughter, that they take pride in their daughters, lie for them, their sons, wanting someone to think that they are so right, and they're full of wickedness. They're full of hell. The wife is wicked. The husband doesn't give a damn. And these are the individuals that justify them. And they put light for darkness and darkness for light, bitter for sweet. They call that which is tough evil, and that which is evil, they call it tov. That is a damn abominable mindset. You might as well respond to me. And there are those that are listening that operate that way. We operate that way. But I am not here to satisfy our flesh. We do that all the day long, don't we? I know I do. Hallelujah. Yesterday it just dawned on me, I thought about a piece of nice pound cake right before the fast. But if I had had a chunk maybe about that big, I would have eaten it. Sure I would have. But I'll rescind on that today. Is that all right? I'm all right now, okay? Maybe I could have gotten up and ran down to the corner store and purchased me 4 or 5 pies and some of those little dainties. But I'm all right now. I will eat the dainties of Yah. Hallelujah. So we cannot say that we love Yah and we have the light in us if we do not keep the Torah of Almighty Yah. Our reconciliation must always come by the dam. That is why this time reminds us of the beauty of Yahshua. Shaul writes it to Romeya, quickly Yisrael, Romans chapter 5 and verse 6. This may not identify you, but it identifies me. Shaul, in the midst of all the delusion and trials, he says, when we, is that not plural? Is that not conclusive to all that he was speaking to? And those that shall read and hear this truth, when we were yet without strength, I did not have the koach of Yah, still do not. Neither do you. Let the poor say, I am rich, and the weak say that I am strong in Yahshua. I don't boast in the capacity of this damn dirty stuff. I'm not ashamed to say that you can. You can think highly of yourself, take heed of yourself, and don't be caught up in your own conceit unless you fall, my friend. No, I do all things through Yahshua. When we were yet weak, without strength, in due time, hallelujah. HaMashiach, Yahshua died for the unrighteous, the Evan. He died for me. Hallelujah. I had no strength to offer anything. But he died for me. That is what this time reminds us of and brings great clarity of this beauty. Let me move. Jehu says, hardly for a Tzaddik man will one die. But a man is righteous, no one will die for him. He said, yet maybe for a Tov man, some would even dare to die. You understand that? They said to Yahshua, Tov master. He said, you call me Tov? He said, there's only one Tov. You know that. The Torah teaches that. That's Yah. But he was implying, you calling me Tov? You know that I'm of Yah. You know that I'm the power of Yah. You know that I'm the truth of Yah. That's what he was saying. That's what he was saying, Yisra'iyah. You call me that? Then your testimony says, I know that you come from Yah. You don't know how to say it, but he is from Yah. But Yah commanded, or he commends his Ahava toward us, in that while we were yet wicked sinners, Messiah died for us. He reminds us, the witness is true. In the mouth of two or three witnesses, let every word be established. Then he gives us something that is much greater. Something that is Rab. He said much more than now, hallelujah, being justified by the dam. You see, that's what this time shows us, that we're justified by the dam, the blood of Yeshua. That's what we should celebrate with great gladness. He said, now justified by the dam, we shall be delivered from the wrath, the agony of Yah through who? Yeshua. That's why it still takes the dam. That's why the blood of Yeshua is of great essence. The blood of Yah, it still takes blood. It still takes blood. Let no one deceive you. For when we were enemies, we were the oyeb of Yah. We were his enemies. He gives us tikva, promise here. He said we were reconciled. The propitiation. We're reconciled to his friendship. He is the propitiation of our sins. We were reconciled to Yah by the death, the maveth of his son. Much more, being reconciled, we shall be delivered by his life. Not only did he offer up the kafa, the covering of our sins, but it was his life and death that brought the salvation unto Yisra'iyah. Hallelujah. We are saved by the dam of Yahshua. That's what saved Yisra'iyah. The blood had to be offered. It had to be offered in the Beit HaKodesh of Yah. The Mikdash is by the blood, Yisra'iyah. It still takes the power of the dam of Yahshua. We're not getting by without it. And that's why Atonement reminds us of the power and the beauty of that. We Shabbat, we celebrate it. With great fervor, we bring the offerings of great excitement. The fire of the promises, the Dama of Yah burns in us. And we offer that unto Yah. Hell, we get more excited about Walmart and Kmart. Damn Walmart. Damn Kmart. There's nothing in Walmart that excites me. I don't give a damn the finest of what they call clothing stores. It doesn't excite me at all. Nothing like that. This is what excites me. When I hear the Torah of Yah, it ignites something in me. When the Torah speaks to my mind, when I'm weary and tired, it calls me to traverse through that book. My mind is awakened, Yisra'iyah. There are things that we're not going to get, but by the obedience unto Torah, we fast or soon denying this flesh. That's the only way, Yisra'iyah. Hallelujah. I conclude here in Romans as to what Shaul speaks. And not only this, but we also boast in Yahweh through our Master Yeshua HaMashiach, by whom, by Yeshua HaMashiach, by whom now we have received the atonement. The Kippur, that's why this Kippurim is a time that we know that what a man celebrates it the way Yah says, it is simple. He says, I want you to fast at the beginning of the evening until the next day evening. That's all he asks us. It's not a difficult thing. This is the sign of seal that we have received Yahshua as our atonement. When we walk in blatant defiance, we say we love them, we keep not his mitzvah, we're damn liars. And that's why the enemy is raising up the groups, the gatherings. You understand the groups and the gatherings of lies to satisfy their damn flesh with jackals and clowns and fools. That's all they are, jackals and clowns and fools, ignorant men of effeminate nature. Because nobody's going to tell them a damn thing. You're not going to tell these effeminate faggot dogs that is not the nature of Yah. And I'm talking about the natural sense. You're not going to tell these spiritual effeminate fag men in the spiritual sense that their actions are not of Yah. It is amazing then how men will speak against me, but they won't challenge me because they don't have the guts. They don't have the spiritual in-depthness of matters. They don't. You're boasting, no. It's simply that I labor a little more than they do. Forgive me, Yah, a lot more. Because I am as ferocious as a big cat, as a lion. And from a child, that was in me. I don't mind losing at anything. I don't get upset because I lose. But you will know what I lost. You have been in a battle. You may have won, but you know you've lost. I've always been that way. As a young boy in the cotton fields, I didn't want nobody to pick more cotton than me. And we look at the adults, of course they were beating me. I can remember occasions. No, I do not remember the sequential order. I don't remember the sequential order of my life from last year this time. How about that? But there are things that are prominent in my mind as we were in the cotton field. I remember. As a little thing, I could see that big burlap sack dragging behind me. But I was enthused about picking that. It was a challenge to me. Only when you began to get a little older, you realized the depth of agony that it created on the back in the mind of man. But that's all right. Those that did that, they came out with a renewed vigor and a strength. You don't find it this damnable, effeminate generation today. Weak men. And I don't take it back. Challenge me, weak man. That's who will challenge me, the weak man. A matter of strength, he delights in that. Why? Because he knows he can lift 50 pounds. But you weak ones challenge me. You effeminate ones will dare. That's the truth. Hallelujah. Can I press a little farther? I want to show you the value. And why we must sum. And that's what the word fasting means, to sum, to afflict, to destroy the nature of one's flesh. That is what the stake of Yahshua when he was impaled did. It ripped and eradicated every tentacles of life of the flesh. And when death challenged that flesh, it found no corruption in it. He did not stink in the grave. Hallelujah. When death challenged that natural biological body, there was no stench of corruption. He did not rot the skin worms, the maggots. That's why during the catching away of the time when Yahshua shall come, there shall be those that are alive, because they shall have the power of that testimony with great fervence. And they shall be caught up to meet him. The body will not taste the stench of the grave. Just at his mere appearance, they shall be as dead men, everyone. And they shall be caught up to meet him in the air. Is this important, the fasting, the sum? I will give us a little detail on that in the latter part of this message as I proceed to the descending of the closing of this, all right? My friend Micaiah, he always said, they have written to me in the past, you just didn't go long enough. Hallelujah. We'll go long enough today, my Ach. We're going to have plenty to eat on this week. Next week, as it began, wonderful gathering. We'll have a great time. I want you to direct your attention to the writings of Jeremiah chapter 36 and verse 1. Again, we greet you all that have joined us on the live broadcast on the Shabbat. We pray that Yah has barak. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh my. Whoa, my. We pray that Yah has barak. And this simple truth will strengthen your resolve on this day, the value and the importance of this time. You cannot denounce it. I direct your attention here in the book of Jeremiah chapter 36. As this Nobi speaks unto Yisrael, the sins, our sins have collectively, individually, been a blot of stain upon the garment of Yahshua HaMashiach. That's why Yah's going to destroy this damn wicked world. There should be no remembrance of the wickedness on this earth. He made it to be a beautiful oasis of his lineage, of his zira, his seed. And we have corrupted everything. And so the Nobi speaks unto Yisrael, Yehuda, as to the state of their mind, what happened to avoid the very indignation of Yah. He says, there must be a khafa. He speaks precisely here. Jeremiah 36:1. It says, and it came to pass in the fourth year of Yahuakim, the one that Yah raises up, the son of Yoshia, whom Yah heals, the Melech of Yehuda, that this word came unto Jeremiah, speaking. Now this is what the word came unto him. This is what the utterance of Yah came unto him to say. He says, I want you to take my son a michgillah, a scroll, a book. I want you to take a parchment. He says, and I want you to hatab, to write, to inscribe in it therein. He did not say some, but he said kol, all the words that I have spoken to you, not far, but against Yisrael, and against Yehuda, and against some of the nations, or all other nations, from the day I spoke to you, from the days of Yoshia, even to this day. It may be that Bayet or the house of Yehuda will shemak all the evil which I purpose to do to them. You tell me that Yah has purpose to do evil unto Yisrael? He said, I want you to hear. I want you to hear. It is a terrible thing to fall into hands of Yah. Yah has purpose. He has established in his bosom to repay the evil upon the nations, of the evil that has been done against Yisrael, to bring them into the captivity of bondage and their sins. They're not getting by. He said, the evil that I shall do to them, that they may return every man from his evil ways. When we consider what Yah is going to do unto us, we consider this day of atonement, then it caused us to consider how evil I have been and my wickedness. And yet Yah allowed us the small few here. The gathering on the live stream is tremendous more that's in here. Then when we consider all that there is an atonement only in Yeshua, that we will consider our evil ways and our sinful ways, that the blood had to cover that. And it should be the power of our testimony that we cover the testimony of God. We cover Yeshua HaMashiach. It is almost like in the days your boy gets into a competitive battle with someone, and you say, no, man, you're not going to do that to my boy. No, no. I'm standing in his stead. You cover for them. We should be covering for Yeshua. We're covering our damn sins and our wickedness, but we're not covering for him. We're covering our wicked ways, but we're not covering for him. He said, I want you to hear me, Yisrael, that you may consider my people, that you may understand, and that every man return, shuba, turn around, jump down, turn around, turn from your sin. That every man turn from his evil ways. Yah says that I may, Sholach, forgive them, that I may pardon them. It is one thing about a pardon. The record is expunged. I want him to Sholach. It takes the blood, and that's what the blood did on that day that he commanded Aharon. It Sholach. It forgave. It expunged the record. There was no writing on the records, Yisrael. No writing on the record. That I may Sholach their iniquity and their sin. When Yah began to speak unto him, he called one that was blessed. His name Baruch represents the best of Yah. It says that then Yirmiyah, he called Baruch, the one that is blessed. He says, the son of Neriah, the one that has the lamp of Yah. Neriah, that has the lamp of Yah. And Baruch wrote, as well, this damnable thing, trust no man, this damn twisted, fallacious doctrine of the whore. A whore trusts no man she lays with. She'll lay with any man. But he knew he had someone that was faithful. His name was Baruch. And he will not write according to his interpretation. But it says, and Baruch wrote, he had time, he inscribed from. So that lets me know that there was a destination or a place from where what he wrote proceeded from. He wrote from the feth, the mouth of Yirmiyah, not in fragmentation, but he wrote what came from the mouth of Yirmiyah, all the word of Yahweh, which he had spoken to him. You know why he did that? Because Baruch was faithful. And in the mouth of two or three witnesses, let every word be established. And for us, what is written, we better allow it to be established in our bosom, Yisrael. We better allow that. He wrote every word which was spoken out of the mouth of Yirmiyah, which he had spoken to him. He said, upon the shefer, the book, the scroll, he wrote it. And Yirmiyah, he savor, he commanded Baruch with strength, with tenacity and power. He did not ask him. He said, he commanded Baruch, saying, I am shut up. I cannot even go into the beit of Yah, the presence of Yah. He says unto this faithful, the blessed one, Baruch, therefore go. I want you to go among Yah's people. As he commands us today, go among them. He says that I want you to read from the shefer, the scroll, which you have written from my mouth. Let them know that this is not your writing. what has come from the messenger's mouth and the Navi of Yah has come from the prophet's mouth. He said the word that about the promises, the word of Yah, he said in their ears of the people in Yah's bayat, when? Upon the sum or the fast day, the day of fasting. This is the day of fasting. And we shall hear what Yah speaks to us on this day of atonement. He said we turn from our evil ways, he will reconcile us. He will be the propitiation, Yahshua. He will restore the friendship. Was Moshe a friend of Yah? Did he speak to him face to face? Are we friends of Yah? Hold, don't answer me so quickly. If we're friends of Yah, he will speak to us face to face. By the revelation of the testimony of Yahshua Mashiach, it will speak in our face. Was not the countenance of Moshe, don't ask me, change? As the fullness of the Son of the people could not look upon him in the presence of Yah. When this testimony becomes real in us, then only then shall we be a city that sit upon a hill, that the light of the power of his edut cannot be hidden, Yisrael. We're phony as hell. I don't take it back. I'm talking to you as well, my friends. Some reason people think I'm talking just to us. I'm talking to Yisrael. You that will hear this, you that by some chance that it may be delivered unto you, I am talking to you, all right? Hallelujah. Okay, are you Yisrael? We are dumb people, are we not? We are sottish. We are stupid. Yah says that. You got a problem, go to him. Hallelujah. He commands him what to do. He said, read it on the day of fasting. And also, you shall read them in the ears of all Yehuda that come out of their cities. The Day of Atonement, they have come out. They're in the city of Yerushalayim as they wait for Sukkoth. They're there. They've been there from day one to the 20th day. They have gathered in their barns. All of their crops are in. The cattle, everything is taking place. And they have taken that journey across the vast land to gather in the city of Yerushalayim. Yerushalayim represents the place where Yah's Shalom is. It should be embedded in our mind that natural land there is of the spirit of Sodom and Egypt. It's a damn corrupt place. It's divided. Palestinian and the Ashkenazis are those that call themselves damn Jews. On the other hand, it's filthy. Every kind of damn harlotry and every kind of vile spirit is there. That's right. Hallelujah. How's it going to be cleansed? By the power of the messengers of Yah. He has two witnesses, Yisrael. It's a damn filthy place. It stinks. It's a divided city. Got the Muslim temple and the whole house of the Jews. Hallelujah. I don't give a damn who's offended. You understand? They offend Yah. They purport this religious ideology. It stinks to hell. It stinks to hell. The city in which spiritually is called Mizraim and Sodom, that's the city of Yerushalayim. We can only keep the Mo'adim in the city of Yerushalayim, in the place where his Shalom resides, in the Ereb, in this earthen vessel. You can go there with false pretense. It doesn't mean a damn thing. They pilgrim to Yisrael by the millions. And the rich, dirty dogs are getting rich off the stupidity of the people. Sure they are. Sure they are. And they believe that they've had some kind of epiphany. Come and walk the streets, quote, where Jesus Christ walked, unquote. How in the hell, in that hour, did you have a Latin, English, Greek man walking up and down the street. Hell, there was no thing called what we call Americas. It was not known as Americas. It could have been a land known as the Kemet, or the dark land of darkness, land of a people, because there were people here when the damn fool Columbus sailed here, sailing toward India. He called who he met Indians. It is the truth. You don't have to be a scholar to understand that. So we are taught this erroneous damn thing we call history, a story of damn lies. This book speaks the truth unto us, people. A dumb fool. This is a stupid generation. And we are part of it. That's why we're ignorant. I know I am. Hallelujah. You can't pump me up with anything else, all right. I know I'm ignorant. May I proceed a little farther? I shall proceed. Hallelujah. You read from the book on this day of fasting, the Day of Atonement, in simple, analogical revelation, the Day of Atonement. Jeremiah 36:7. Why? It may be that they will present their tikh and their supplication. And it is a supplication, it is a petition unto Yah, whereby one... It is a petition where one cries out unto Yah with an earnest effort. You ever seen people crying, you know it's fake and phony? This is a howling from the bosom. Tikhena, tikhena. That's what supplication is. It is an earnest desire. He said that they should present their supplication, their earnest petition before Yah, and they will return some of them, a few of them, a little of them. So are we a part of that EVERY? Of everyone from his. Did not everyone have to bring an offering of the sin offerings? Return from his evil ways. For great is the anger, his king resentment, and the Chama, the rage, the heat of his indignation, and great is the fury that Yah has pronounced. You tell me that Yah has pronounced that? He said that Yah has daba, he has spoken, he has uttered. He said Yah has done that. Did he not pronounce there in the book of Yira that if any man labor and then do not fast, they're going to be cut off, they're going to be all bad, they're going to be karath? Did he not state that? You see the corruption of our damn flesh that defies Yah. We say we love him. We don't keep his instructions. We can Shema the feast days of Yah. And I will, here in this damn corrupt nation, I will keep them. They want to debate as to the Pacific of the days, and men want to formulate these calculations that are so damnable, erroneous. And it makes them think that they have a wisdom to dispense it. They don't have a damn thing. As I said to you, after the feast days, I will show you with definitive, with word meanings in its original form, and you will understand it in a great light. It's going to be a great blessing. I don't care if you're in the boondocks of the wilderness, you will know the time of the feast days of Almighty Yah, the Mo'adim. Hallelujah. And Yah's will, we may write a booklet in the process of that. I'll teach it and write it. How about that? He's saying this time, Jeremiah 36:8, and Baruch the son of Neriah did according to all. He did according to all that Jeremiah the Navi commanded him, reading the Shefer, the word of Yah, in Yah's Bayat. Men don't do that today, do they? You command someone. They rise up in their own indignation, but he did all that Yah commanded. Is the sum of the fasting important? Surely is Yisrael, that we deny our flesh. And I will show some examples of that in closing. Hallelujah. I want to begin here and show you one that we all are familiar with in the book of Yohanan. Jonah chapter 3, and just one verse I want to read. Jonah chapter 3, hallelujah. Again, you are listeners and friends. Today we greet you in Yeshua's name, hallelujah. We do need your support. You help us that we may be able to broadcast on the live stream without the interference and all the commercials. So let Yah move upon your heart to assist us, Yisrael, hallelujah. It says in the book of Jonah, it speaks of those that are in Nineveh when the Nobi came to instruct them as to Yah's fury, his wrath, his king resentment, his anger that should be poured out. And as the men and the women heard, they repented or their hearts. And this is when one truly trusts Yah, they will make this. When we trust this hour and the time, we will do what Yah commands us. And when we don't, we will go about our own ways. And then once we forget, then the wrath and the vengeance of Yah, as it was in Nineveh, shall be poured out upon us. And the latter end is going to be worse. It says here in the book of Jonah, 3 and verse 5, so the men, the men of Nineveh, it said they believed, didn't it? They believed Yah. They believed Almighty Yahweh, didn't they not? That's what it says. It did not say that they cried out. It said they believed Yah. You must believe him, Yah. If we as a nation of people come to him, we must first believe that he is the reward of them that what diligently seek him. So they sought him because they believe, and they believe Yah, and proclaim a sum, a fast, and they put on sackcloth from the greatest of them even to the least of them. If our illustrious president, Mr. Barack Hussein Obama, these men are coming up with all their program that's going to save this wicked whore, and they're not going to save it. They're coming up with these catchphrases like these damn preachers. This is the year of plenty. 2012 will be the year that you're not caving in. They always got these catchphrases. I got a program, Mr. Herman McCain, 999. You know, it's not going to work, Yisrael. If Barack Obama presidents, Mr. President Barack Hussein Obama, will stand up and say we're going to fast and tell this nation it's wicked. He's a cowardly man. It is amazing how cowardly these men are. Mr. Barack Hussein Obama, he went to what they call the Black Caucuses of Congress. He spoke to them and said, stop your complaining, take off your slippers, put on your boots, and let's work. When then the same effeminate damn weak man, let him tell the damn conservatives to shut your damn mouth, stop your damn complaining. Let him tell the damn Tea Party, shut your damn mouth. He told them that, and because they are so faithful and loyal, Negroes are that way. Say what you want to. They're faithful to the oppressor. It's something in that people that it amazes me of all people. They're still faithful. And after he scolded them like children, they came out and said, hooray, we will still stand by you. And tell Mr. Rush Limbaugh to shut his damn mouth, and Mr. Bill O'Reilly, he can't do that. He's afraid of those men. But he went among that little simple people of collection of men, just a few of them there. Just a few. And said, shut your damn mouth. Yes, sir. We are ignorant people. You'd rather read the funniest than read something like that. For this we are willingly ignorant. We are an ignorant people. We want to be ignorant. Tell the whole nation, shut your damn mouth. Tell the rich to shut your damn mouth about taxes and griping like a dog. You rich bastard. I was thinking this morning, as Mr. Steve Jobs of Apple, he died the other day. And this man is an icon. He is a god to the business sector. And I thought, I said, yeah, with all of his billions, he could not stay alive. 56 years old. The finest of physicians. Some of the most advanced medicine that one could even think of. He had it. And yet he went the way of all men. The way of the grave, he shall go. And he died. You can purport him as this great panacea, the cure for all of the economy. You're a damn lie. Mr. Obama cannot cure this economy. If they paid no damn taxes, it won't cure this economy. Because there's a love of money, and it is the root of all the damn evil in this land. Prostituting your sons and your daughters, you prostituting yourself, wife, you prostituting yourself, man. It's not going to change one damn thing. His wrath is coming upon all nations, man. You hear me? Not just some, but all the nations. And they are crumbling because they're built upon a premise of wickedness, of capitalizing on the weak. And the poor, the way you treat the poor, the way you, it shows a sense of gravity and sense. That is right, man. And there were those brought to this nation in the shackles of poverty. The average family of the Caucasian is $114,000. The average wealth of the Caucasian is $114,000. The average wealth of what we call the Hispanics is $6,175. Do you hear me? Oh, this isn't that thing you all read, them things you get up there in the dining hall. And the average wealth of the people of the diaspora is $5,150. They don't have a damn thing but broken backs and broken spirits. We need someone that know be the messengers. They're damn liars. You've never had a dream to come true, have you? No, you haven't. I don't give a damn if you are a psyche. That's why they tell you to fantasize. You can dream here. Hell, the mama that's dreaming that her baby is hungry. That's all she's doing, dreaming. The mother's dreaming that her baby is hungry and that her little pension is cut off. That's all she's doing. This is the wicked nation. What do we do unto the least of those? When we see those that we consider least, what we do unto them, even they're not Israel, you do it unto Yah. So you do no man wrong. I don't care who he is, you don't do any man wrong. You do right by them. You do right. I don't give a damn if he's an atheist or Muslim, Jew, Christian. You do right by every man. You don't do them wrong. You don't try to finagle, to rob, to steal, to cheat them. No. I give you an honest day's labor. Zachin said to me, Reak, the job we're doing, we're not making one dime. And believe me, they didn't make a dime on that. He made enough money to put gas in the vehicle. And that was basically it. That was it. Three powerfully built men, strong backs. And then they got to deal with the element of this damn twisted world. They didn't make anything. But that's all right. You see, there were those that came by and saw the beauty of their work and said, you'll do that? Sure, give me a card. Give me that. Hallelujah. You do right by all men. You do wrong by no man. Even your enemy, you do right by. Vengeance is mine, says Yah, I will repay. Hallelujah. You do right by them, Yisrael. And so from the least of the greatest of them in Nineveh, they repented before Almighty Yah. We're in a time of the locusts, and the locusts in Torah, the arbeb or the abeb, the locusts represent that which eats away. What's eating at us, Yisrael? I hear from people, the emotions, the circumstances, the husband, their wives, their children, it is just eating up what Yah sows into them. You hear the muscles of His Torah, that is why this time of atonement is to restore us, whereby there's a fire that ignites in us. That's why they gathered in Jerusalem, and they saw those that were weak in just the sight of each other cause a strength to rise up in their bosom. So He calls one by the name of Joel, the prophet Joel, Joel chapter 1, to prophesy and to speak unto us. Joel 1:13. He tell us to gird. You understand what to gird is? That our loins should be girded about with truth, our hearts, our minds. To gird, to put the belt or that which secures us, the girder. He said, I want you to gird yourself. We need to get truth in our hearts. And we began to lament. He says, you that are the Kohan, the Kohen. He said, I want you to yalla, I want you to howl, I want you to wail like a beast. You ministers of the altar, you that are the Zokain that minister unto baptism in the house of Yisrael. He said, I want you to wail at the altar. He said, come lie all night in sackcloth, you ministers of Yah. We don't lie nowhere before Yah. We don't even spend time in His Torah all night. He said, come lie all night, you minister of Yah. He said, for the meat offering, there's no substance. Yoshua said, I would love to give you meat. I must feed you milk because you're still yet babes. I would love to feed you meat, Yisrael. So that's why there's no meat offering today. We don't stand in the strong power of His truth. He said, the meat offering and the drink offering is withholden from the bed of Yah. There's no meat in Yah's house, Yisrael. We don't offer up the things that are of great substance and strength to teach Yisrael that we may abide in the ways of Yah to become strong. It takes meat to be strong, Yisrael. Yah says, I want you to kadash or consecrate. He said, I want you to have a fast. This is the time that we consecrate. To hell with Bobo, Mickey D, and that damn trash that's killing us, your chips and your fries. He said, I want your mind to be consecrated. When our minds are consecrated, we're not thinking about a damn piece of pie. We're thinking about the food, the meat, the body of Yeshua. He said, take, drink my blood and eat my flesh, for it is what? Meat indeed. And when we eat that body, we offer up the meat offering and we bring that testimony of power to Yah's house because we know we have the atonement of Almighty Yah. Hallelujah. Is this making sense? You that are listening, if it's making sense, send me an amen. All right. Hallelujah. It is uttering out of me. I don't hear it in the perfection that you will hear it, but I will hear it after it's all over with. All right. He said, assemble, gather the, consecrate your fast, call a solemn assembly. And he said, you gather the Zochim, the elders, and all the inhabitants in the land of the bed of Yah. You understand? He said, gather the elders. And they should not be little simple, petty-minded men, juvenile in their damn actions and immaturity. Should be ministry. I will, man. He said, gather the elders. Gather the Zakane, their actions, their deeds have been seen by the young men, that they're strong men, their attitude, their actions, they see their labor. Hell, we see today men that are juvenile and petty as hell. And that's the truth. And that's what among Yisrael I shall preach, my friend. When Yah truly removed the Zakane, the nation goes down to the gates of hell. You got silly elderly men and stupid old men. Don't have a damn thing. You got silly old women. That word Zakin represent men and women. You should have Zakin. The women should be strong and mature and have an elderly statehood about them. Hell, they're mean as hell. grumpy, nasty as hell. Us ain't taking a damn word back. Imparted to baptism alone, the strength and the beauty of the testimony of their heart. Other men act like damn children. Act worse than boys. I shall, my friend. Even boys don't even act like them. It's a damn shame. And elders, I can't have the strength to man any situation and command and to instruct. Because his life is a representation of the Torah, the commands of Yah. You find these weak. That's why in this day a man is going to be more valuable than the gold of Oprah. It's hard to find a man. Yes, I'm going to remove all the men from among them. I ain't no men today. That includes you and me, hallelujah. From Yah's definition of a man. Your definition, because you got broad shoulders and you got the anatomy, that doesn't mean a damn thing. Hallelujah. As a man, he has the power, the authority of Yeshua at his head. He doesn't slip, slide away. He continues in the Yalach and the way, the path of Yah. Talk to me. Hallelujah. He said, you call the solemn assembly for this day. Get the elders, the Zaken, and all the inhabitants of the land into the bed of Yah. Are we not in the bed of Yah today? That's why it's vital for people, you know. Come on, you all that are listening. Put away your damn vacation days. Quit spitting them in folly. Go to some kind of damn dreamland. Carnival activities. Your damn wicked ten folks. You come and gather with Yisrael. Visiting the amusement park. What a damn shame. What a damn shame. I don't take it back. We have, when it comes to Yah's days and time, well, I can't go. You spend $1,000 at the damn amusement park. It won't give Yah a nickel. What a damn dirty, wicked one. I'm talking to you as well, my friend. And I don't take a word back. Brother Jeff Krause wrote me from Toledo. He said, Riak, don't change nothing. Preach. You got someone listening. And he proves it by his gifts and offerings too. Yah Barak, my friend. Hallelujah. So, you that don't do a damn thing, don't even think you can tell me not to talk like this. This man says, talk like that, and he proves it with his gifts. Who am I going to obey? Him. Hallelujah, I will, my friend. He said, alas, the day of Yah is at hand, and to show the havoc of his violence, the destruction from the most powerful Yoshariah. Did he say, might come or shall come? It shall. It shall come. The day of his destruction is come. And that's what this time reminds us that the beauty of Yeshua atoning for us, because this is a day that you don't want to be a part of in the sense that you're in opposition of Almighty Yah. That's why we fast today and we hold fast to what Yah commands. We have all done things in the world and those whorehouses. We got to fast 3 days. But it was not the call sum of Yah. And two more things I want to point out to us, Yisrael, in the book of Yeshaya again, Isaiah chapter 58. You got to know the real deal from the false. There's a counterfeit, all right? And there's a true fast. And the true fast of Yah reveals the real righteousness is Sadiq, Sadiq. The Nabi speaks in Jeremiah 58, verse 3, for expedience of time. Yah says, they say to Yah, this is how we talk. We think we don't talk to Yah this way. Are we the people of Yah? Are these the people of Yah? Now look how they talk to Yah. Wherefore, they say to Yah, why we fast? Wherefore we have sum, they say. I've done all I could. I've been nice to him, nice to her. You haven't even been nice to yourself. You haven't even loved yourself. Why do we fast? They're saying to Yah, like we've done something so valuable. Hell, he fed us bread and meat all week. Yeah. That's right, Emo. Clap them hands. Yeah. Why do we fast? They say, is it not that the description in the book in Yohanna? They say, and yet you, they're talking to Yah, and yet you do not see us. I did something nice and you didn't see it. I was in the garden for 2 hours. You didn't see it.
I did that and I didn't get no compliment.
This is a damn twisted mind. And say, so you don't even see us. This is the boldness and the brazen attitude of this damn generation.
They say, why have we afflicted our nephesh? And you take no knowledge. You don't even see our, quote, good deeds, unquote.
Your deeds are dirty and filthy. They're wicked.
See, Yah says, in the day of your fast, you do your own pleasure. Well, I'm fasting because I just need to work on me. See, that's your own pleasure.
Yes, it is, my friend.
He said, for your own pleasure, while keeping your labors working in the field. You say you keep the moedim, you say you're a Jew, and yet you keep your labors in the field working. Talk to me, Yisrael. You say that you're Israelite, and yet your flesh is laboring. It's in the field of the world. Did not the sower go and sow in the field? Is not the field of the world? Is not the field of the world? It all adds up in Torah. And then the one that sowed evil seed, did he not come and sow? Is not the field classified as the olam? Our minds are worldly and wicked.
That is the truth. You keep your labors working hard. You keep your flesh working hard. See, Yah says your fast or your soon lead to strife and contention.
You start fasting, you're mad as hell. You're hungry, you're greedy, you're moody. Talk to me, Yisrael.
You can sit here all you want to. You can sit there and listen. But it's all about contention. You get angry as hell. You get moody as hell. We get wishy-washy as hell. Our mind is on a piece of cupcake, shitty banana pie pudding. It's not on the beauty of Torah. So Yah say, I call one.
Zechariah called for, he talked about the fast in the second month, the fourth, fifth month, the seventh month, and the ninth month.
I'll get to that one day if one of you all don't. It's all right with me. You can handle it.
He said, but your fasting is based upon contention and strife and to hitting with violent blows. You're fasting and yet your mind is still full of the same damn mess it was 10 atonements ago. You got some of the same vile wickedness in us. Fasting on a day like today will not make your voice heard, will not make your voice to be heard on high.
Yah says, because you fast, that doesn't mean I'm going to hear you. You think you're doing something, Yah say, damn, you fast. You're full of your damn wickedness. We're cleansed by the hearing of Torah. You don't want to hear a damn thing. You think you know everything.
He said, you think that's what we do. Don't worry, I'm just fasting because I'm just going through something. I'm fasting. Yah say, you think I hear your damn cries because you're fasting? He said, go to hell. You got bush in you. You got a lot of damn mess in you. And after that fast, you'll go back to that 3 days later. And you say, I got stuff in me to come out. You're damn full of wickedness.
We'll cleanse Yisrael by the hearing of his Torah. You don't know how to hear. And you think because you fast, that's going to remedy it.
Hell, the world fasts all the time. Yogism teaching the fast all the time. Buddhism teaching the fast all the time. You're not doing a damn thing. The Muslim, the Ramadan. The Catholics, every Friday, they used to fast. It is the truth, man.
So we think that because we fast, we're going to be heard. Not so. This is the day he say fast, and I shall hear you. He shall hear the sweet fragrance of our offering, our incense, the fire that burns in us. He shall hear us. Hallelujah. Is this such a fast that I have chosen?
We say we're fasting, but Yah say, have I chosen that for you?
Has he chosen this fast?
Sure he has. This soon he has chosen. This the one he has chosen. This the one he has ordained. He said, a day for a man to afflict his nephesh.
Is the object to hang your head down like a reed?
When you're supposed to afflict your soul, your nefesh, should you have your head all down? Well, I'm just fasting. You can't hardly move. Just, I'm fasting. I've been fasting a day. That's the way we are. You can talk any way you want to. We're full of our damnable hypocrisy. We're just like the Pharisee. We want everybody to know we're fasting. I fast 3 times a week. Look at me. We want everybody to know it. Y'all say, I appoint a date that all Yisrael fast, and everybody know it. And so we want everybody to know we're fasting, so we have our head down. When a man fasts, let him first of all wash your face. Did we wash our face this morning? Okay, then. I anoint his head. I anoint his mind with coconut oil, all right? Yeah. As granted, which I grass my face and I grass my head, I grass my beard with coconut oil, okay? And then he walk upright and straight. He says, full of bull, shysting. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Is the object of your fast to hang your head down like a reed and to spread sackcloth and ashes under yourself? Will you call this a fast? And an acceptable day to Yahweh. Is not this the fast that I have chosen? Is not this the fast when Yah, he has caused us to fast on this day? He has chosen that. For what reason? To patach, to loosen, to break, to set free. That's what Yahshua came to do. Whom the Son makes free is free. Indeed, and we're free to fast. We're not bound by the driven emotions and the desire of our flesh. We're free to do it on Yah's time in his ordination. It is to loose the bands of wickedness. That's what this is about. I've been wicked. I have not told a Yah. Don't know how to open my mouth unto Yah. Come before him. Don't know how to say Todah, praise Yah. He said, that's wickedness, to break the bands of wickedness, to throw them down and to undo the heavy burdens. To undo these heavy yokes upon us and the burdens under this captivity, and to let the oppressed go free, and that you may break, that you, Yisrael, you said shackles, you coming of the, you may break every metah. Every yoke, every band, every heavy, cumbersome thing of your mind and your body, you break it off you. That's why he called this. I don't care your circumstances at home, to break the burdens. I don't care your situations, the battle, to break the burdens. I want to close with an example of that, of this fast, and the results of a true fast. I will close with that. Is that all right? I shall anyway. David says here in Tehillim, Psalms 35, verse 11, as he began to complain to Yah about the forces of darkness, his enemies against him, he says to Yah, Tehillim 35, 11, he calls them false, but they're Hamas, they're violent, evil men, our enemies, and false men, and false, what we call false brothers. They're violent and they're cruel. They operate in some of the most unjust ways that are so wicked. He said, false witnesses did rise up, and they laid to my charge things I didn't even know I had done. You tell me someone laid to your charge and say you're doing this with such vile indications of your act and deeds. That is a Hamas. That's a wicked, cruel, damn devil of a dog. They rewarded me evil for tov to the bereaving of my flesh. I cried when I tried to do right by them. They rewarded me evil. When I did them no harm, they still rewarded me evil. He says, but as for me, when they were challa, they were sick, weakly in their diseases, he said, my clothing was sackcloth, a sack. I humble my nefesh. This is what this day is about, to humble ourselves, not to fight against Torah, his commands. He said, I humble my nephesh with fasting, and my tefillah returned back into my bosom. Yah says, I did not appoint that day for you. This is the day he has appointed for us to fast. Yisrayatusum. And there's one sign of this fast that we all will be touched and afflicted by. And that we, as I conclude here, he speaks here in the book of Tehillim. Psalms 109 verse 24. Psalms 109 verse 24, he says, my knees are kasha, they are weak. I'm teetering, I'm staggering. He said, my knees are kashal through fasting, and my flesh fails of fatness. So it's supposed to make you weak, and your flesh is supposed to fail. That's the whole key of Yah's time, that we do not rely upon the constitution of our flesh. And when we fast on this day, when we fast according to Yah's instruction, he shall reveal unto us the revelation of his purpose to us. And Daniel Yah, as I close, speaks here so faithfully and so profoundly here in the book of Daniel. Daniel Yah, chapter 9, verse 3. When he considered the time of the captivity of Yisrael, they were in captivity, Yisrael. And this was in the first year of the reign of Darius that he sought Yah. And he says here in Daniel 9:3, he said, I set my face to the sovereign Yah. We must set our affection on things that are above, must we, and not on the things of the earth. That is where our affection must be. I set my ponim upon Yah to seek by tefillah, sincere prayer, with supplication, the earnest purpose and intent, with fasting, sackcloth, and ashes. So that's what he wants us to do, to abandon the sackcloth. Or the sack represents abandoning all the will and the purpose of the flesh, abandoning the desire of the flesh, that the will of Yah be done. What is his pleasure today? That we honor the Moed of Yah this feast. May the riches of Yah rest upon you all in Yahshua's name. May his blessings on this day of atonement strengthen you, all you that have joined us. May he cause his light to shine in your bosom. I'm going to ask Josipia to just come and play a song for me. And then I want to anoint us all today with oil. I want us to come on this day of atonement. And we're going to anoint you all, Yisrael, as you come. Hallelujah. With the oil of gladness, with the oil of Yah. You know, the liars sell bottles like this. The Benny Hins and all of them say that they have medicinal power and all of that. No, the power is in that we do it by faith. Kepha said, silver and gold I don't have, but I have Torah truth, but such as I have, I give unto you in the name of Yahshua HaMashiach. Rise and be healed. So we're going to rise in that name, and we're going to allow the Torah of Yah to heal us. Hallelujah. We shall rise in the name of Yahshua. We shall rise in the name of Yahshua. Yes, we shall. Healing, oh, the healing power. Oh, the healing power of Yah. Only in Yahshua's name. It is only in Yahshua's precious name. It is only in Yahshua's name, only in that name, oh, the healing,
healing power of Yah. It can only come, only come in Yeshua's name. So we rise. Oh, we rise. Let us stand to our feet. Oh, we rise. Oh, we rise. Oh, we rise. Only in, only in Yeshua's name. Oh, we rise. Oh, we rise. Only in, only in the name of Yeshua, oh, we rise. Yes, we rise. Only in the name of Yeshua, Israel, rise. In the name Yeshua, come on, we're going to anoint you with oil. I'll play that song. Oh, we rise. Come on, Israel, lift your hands. We rise in Yeshua's name for your healing, Yah. Hallelujah. Ah, your healing power and your healing strength in Yeshua's name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Restore and heal in Yeshua's name. Hallelujah. Oh, we rise in Yeshua's name, his healing power. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Oh, the healing of God in Yeshua's name, your atonement. It is by your mighty power, your healing. Lift them hands up. In Yeshua's name, hallelujah. Oh, the healing power of God in Yeshua's name, hallelujah. Oh, we rise and we'll heal in Yeshua's name. The all of healing and gladness in Yeshua's name. Oh, heal ya. Oh, we rise and we are healed. Oh, we are healed in the name of Yeshua. Oh, we're healed. Heal ya in Yeshua's name. Oh, we're healed. Oh, yes, ya, rise and be healed. In Yeshua's name, the healing power, hallelujah. Oh, rise, hallelujah, hallelujah. Oh, we rise, heal God. In the name of Yeshua, heal us, Yah. Oh, mama, hallelujah. Oh, we heal, hallelujah. In the name of Yeshua, oh, we are healed. The healing power. Only Yah can heal us. Oh, you healing, Yah. Hallelujah. Yah, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, the healing of Yah. Oh, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Heal. Oh, the healing power. Of Yeshua, oh, hallelujah, oh, heal, oh, heal us all, yeah, heal us all, ah, yes, hallelujah, oh, the healing power,
yes,
ah, the healing power of Yah, hallelujah, hallelujah, oh, we rise in the name of Yeshua. Come on, we rise, hallelujah, oh, in his name, hallelujah, 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 ah, yes, hallelujah, hallelujah, oh, we rise, oh, we rise, hallelujah, hallelujah, oh, hallelujah, oh, oh, yes, Yah. Oh, we rise in Yeshua's name. Oh, we rise. Hallelujah. 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 Oh, we rise. Yahshua, oh, we do Yah, as no other, no other name. There is no other Yah, oh, hallelujah, hallelujah. Holy in the name, holy in the name of Yahshua, hallelujah. Come on, lift your hands and shout hallelujah. Come on, hallelujah. In your homes, wherever you are, come on, hallelujah. Lift your hands unto the Yah. And all from the offering of fire, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. For Yahshua, hallelujah. Only in the name, hallelujah. There's healing only in that name. Ah, yes. Great is your name, Yah. Great is Yah. Great is your covenant with Israel. Hallelujah. You that have joined us, we appreciate you all, even our enemies. Because Yahshua commands us, if our enemies are hungry, feed them. And I fed you my Oyed today, my even my enemies. Hallelujah. I say to you, Beit Yisrael, may the riches of Yah, Yahshua HaMashiach, rest upon you all. We shall go to our dwellings and rest from all labor today. Just enjoy the abundance of His riches, the fellowship in Yahshua HaMashiach. We that are here, we shall gather in the dining hall at 6:45, the close of this day, the sun sets. We will have prayer and fellowship from there. To you all, may the riches of Yah rest upon you all, and Yahshua may strengthen the bosom of Kol Yisrael. Let us turn toward the city, Yerushalayim, as He commands us, and lift our hands. For we have nothing to offer but our hands. As we surrender to imply our bosom is open unto you, we yield all to you, Almighty Yah, Yahshua's mighty name. We ask you this day, we know that this time of Kafar, the atonement, that we are cleansed, we shall go into your feast days with great delight, as we shall gather here on Tuesday evening of this week at the sunset to celebrate your most beautiful gathering, your season of Sukkah. Bless your people, those that will join us, protect them in their travel, and guide us and watch over us. We berach you for Arach Michaya, Michael, Tisephaniah, and the son. Berach them, Yah, and all Yisrael scattered wherever they are. Guide us this day. Teach us the simplicity of your truth, and touch us all, and anoint us with the fire of gladness. We ask it all in Yahshua's name as we berach Yerushalayim. You shall prosper them that berach Yerushalayim. Keep and help us all. We ask these simple, beautiful blessings in the most beautiful name of Yahshua HaMashiach. We berach you. And with our voices, we cry hallelujah. 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 Yabarach Yisrael. Oh, yes, only in the name of Yahshua. Hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah, hallelujah. Ah, the beautiful name of Yahshua.